everyone, welcome back to Dragalia Lost. We are here today for another Kaleido showcase, and I am actually recording this before the standard showcase that I have planned for this Sheila week, but I will actually release the normal showcase first. I am doing this before it to get, of course, the prints for Sheila and her showcase, since I want to make it kinda thematic, even though I will change the wheel print part of the normal showcases because of how messed up the wheel print system is now. Sheila is also a very, very fun adventurer into the Kaleidoscape, and as usual we will follow the usual schedule of the Kaleido showcases, so Folio, Standard Floor Showcase, and then Boss Floor Showcase. I should say that by now we have done so many of these that I shouldn't repeat every time what I should do, but for the Folio, as usual, recommended equipment, difficulty rating, and then a small description of the character. The big part of the description, you will find it into her personal showcase. Here I will only highlight the stuff that is relevant into the Kaleidoscape. For example, the defense amp is very good into the standard showcase because of PvE mods. In the Kaleidoscape it is good, yes, but not as big of a problem if you think about it. Anyway, as usual, we will check out the last 5 floors, 4 standard floors, 1 boss floor, and it will be quite the fun time. Sheila is a really, really, really good character. Let's start with the passive. So, how does Sheila work? Much like Gadoff, she has a skill chain sort of system. So she has, let's put it into word, an S1, an S2, and a buff. The buff, which you gain from, I believe it is the Way of the Bladeswolf, every 7th attack that she does into a combo will give her the buff. Whenever you gain the buff, if you chain 2 skills, when you chain the second skill, for example, S1 to S2, then you consume the buff and the buff gives back the S1. If instead it was S2 into S1, you consume the buff and then you gain the S2. So you get generally how this works. Which one you want to use into this mode? Well, the best combo generally is the S2, S1, S2, because the S2 basically does way more damage because it is guaranteed to crit as long as you have the S1 debuff onto the enemies, and has a bigger range. So in standard floors it is way better. In boss floors, critting always is a pretty good thing, if you think about it, because it deals a ton of damage. S1, S2, S1, it's better whenever the boss does not have any kind of debuff onto him. For example, if you need to apply the Flame Rest Down and one Affliction, then it is best to start S1, S2, S1, and then you go S2, S1, S2. Generally, however, I will say that in most floors you will just do S2, S1, S2, because it is just way, way better. And this is the main mechanic that Sheila has. Her standard attacks are much like Galazetia, because you can, for example, let's do 1, 2, 3 standard attack, then you can dodge only once, and if you attack immediately after, instead of restarting from 1, you start with 4, and then you can continue 5, etc. So, much like Galazetia, she has a good support for dodge, which is pretty relevant in this mode, as you will see. Let's see what the passive adds. So, whenever you apply the debuff with the S1, you also get a modifier to critical damage, and S2 always crit. The dodge already explained. Ah, yes, of course. This one is pretty important. Whenever you use one of her skills, she gains super armor. Basically, she cannot be interrupted by armor, by attacks or stuff like that. And then also damage taken will be reduced by 50%. This is big, especially on those last floors, because it means that you always want to open fights by using her skills. The less damage you take, the more attacks you can do. Sheila is, after all, a melee character, and I have an hard time on higher floors, as we've seen in the past, so I highly recommend that you use her super armor to tank those attacks and make it an easier time for her. Then we have double res and crit damage jump and death pump. Overall, Sheila, how does she play? Very fast in many ways, thanks to the fact that she also has movement speed increase. Very strong, huge damage, huge range, capable of dealing with any enemy. Fragile, their main problem is just that you need to pay attention that she does not die because she's always on the front lines. That can be quite a big problem. So let's start with the equipment. In terms of dragons, what do you want? Well, as you can see, my choice was quite, let's say, spread. I got very lucky by getting critical damage early on. This is the best choice for her since she always crits. So if you can maximize critical damage, it is the best. Then I will say strength and then skill damage. Vigor rate is not as much needed. I had to pick it. It is probably the worst choice. To recap it, I will go critical damage, strength, skill damage, and then HP and death, which can be quite helpful because, as I told you, she's quite fragile, so you do need some sort of resistance if you can afford it. Now we have, of course, the weapons. For weapons, you want to prioritize a healing skill. In terms of stats, HP equal to strength. She does a ton of damage, so you don't really need to go overboard with the strengths. For weapons, you want to get ideally Burn or Scorch and Punisher, Strength or, in some cases, even Critical Damage if you can find it. Do not go for Critical Rate once again. Combo Time is kinda pointless because she does a ton of hits very quickly. You want Passive Strength if you can afford it, for sure. In terms of passive for the weapon, I would heavily recommend once again Critical Damage. It is one thing that you will keep hearing from me whenever it is about Sheila, because it is, after all, very true. Now, for the skills, instead, I will go all healing. She has Dispel, she has Afflictions, she has everything that you need. I would keep maybe Sylas, because of the strength reduction, which can help tank some hits. Everything else should be healing, which is why our main objective on those last 4 floors will be to gain as much healing as we can. If she can heal herself, she can attack more. That is a pretty easy and standard thing to understand. So how would I rank Sheila? Easily a 1 out of 5. Very fast, very fun, very strong. Easy to handle, easy to master. The only problem, as I told you, is that you need to pay attention to not go overboard with your fun and make sure that she does not die. But easily, one of the strongest adventurers into the Kaleidoscape, the fact that she can move so fast is also a huge help. Ok, so now let's start with the standard floor. As I told you, you want to start the fights by going into her skills, even if you do not have her buff, because of the damage that you get reduced by using them, and because, as you can see, you make it easier on Sheila to dodge every attack. Now, if you haven't gotten Sheila, I guess that's what you might be thinking of. Wow, she has some sick animations, and yes, you are completely right, and as you can see, this is the general combo that she does, as I told you. Sheila is a very fun character, very fun animation, very fast, as you can see, and one that has an easy time with most enemies. As you can see, the dodge is kinda similar to Yukimura, if I had to make an example, and with good reason I find it pretty perfect for this mod, because it makes an easier job in dealing with most movement related stuff, and in general being able to dodge and keep attacking is a pretty huge thing. Now, this is the first time that I play Sheila, because of course I haven't done the PvE showcase yet, but I can tell you that this character will probably stay in the fire meta for a long while. She is very strong, she is very fun, and most of all, she has what I will call a kit that is too loaded to need anyone else to replace her. As you can see, on the standard floor, your general idea will be to do your rotation, get the buff, then do the standard attacks, and until the skills are ready, then you start spamming skills, and then all over again. You need to pay attention to one thing, which is of course the fact that during standard attacks she's not immune to damage, so you will take damage if you aren't careful. This is why she has a dodge that can resume her attacks after it is done. So make sure to use that dodge as much as you can, because it is a lifesaver between your every attack. Also remember that when a skill ends, as you saw right there, the damage is possible to be taken from a mob. So you need to be very careful when you time skills, not to get caught by a very dangerous attack, because that can be quite deadly for Sheila. But as you can see, against a menace enemies we had no problem at all. As you can see, normal enemies as well, the damage is very much present. This is why she's a 1 out of 5, because I just tap, any enemy dies. Bosses probably bring the most difficulty to this character, because bosses, of course, you have less room for mistakes, which means that Not one mistake and you die, but it is way more likely that your mistake can cost you your run. And, yes, of course, in this case I didn't tell you, we have Volk. Volk is one of those bosses that will be kinda easy for Sheila, in my opinion, because of the fact that she has double resistance, so it's not as much of a worry into most things, but I will really need the heal to dispel the plague, because otherwise the plague will stun Sheila, and that's a big problem indeed. Let's see what we got in terms of skills. Nice. Two healing. Okay, we are loaded up. I am probably going to replace Mumu skills as well, or other meme. I keep healing Mumu because of the fact that the main story calls her Mumu. But here we are. Let's go onwards. As you can see, it doesn't even take too long to clear this mode with Sheila, which is why probably she's going to be Kaleidogore in terms of fire dagger farming or fire in general. Let's see how she does by pulling the entire room of normal NPCs. So this is not, of course, one of the best ideas, but since I am at the maximum level by now and I got all the skills that I need, I can afford to do this, just to show you guys how she does. Hopefully I won't die, but I shouldn't, because I am being pretty careful in doing this. So let's start by showing you how big a range of skills can be. As you can see, we have some healers here, some group of enemies paired up. I healed two healers with the guaranteed crits of this skill. So you can do a huge pack, then pull her S2, S1, S2. It is a pretty big damage dealing skills. The fact that she also has, of course, the instant generation of skill points thanks to this mode helps a lot, of course. In the standard fights, PvE, she doesn't have this added bonus, but I can guarantee you that it won't make too much of a difference because she's still very, very strong regardless of that. You need, as you can see, only to pay attention to her HP. For example, I'm seeing that I am taking quite a beating from the smaller mobs because of the healing that they get from this pesky healer here on the backline. Actually, didn't see it before. But luckily, now he's caught into my barrage of attacks, so he shouldn't be able to heal them anymore. There we go. Okay, actually resisted because I missed with the dash. Just remember, whenever you are dealing with multi-hit enemies, it is fine to use skill. Do not think that you need to use only standard attacks, because multi-hit enemies can be quite tricky if you aren't careful, especially if they have an healer that is bugging them up, as we are seeing right here. I believe that they are the characters over there, yes. Healers are, as indeed, quite pesky as you can get, especially if you aren't careful, but luckily this one will die only of standard attacks, and then we go and get this other one over here. Very nice, so this is how she performs against an entire room. Something that generally I don't show you guys because it takes a lot of time to do, but in this case, since the Zero is so fast in many different ways, then I guess it is easier to set up. There we go, this should be it, and I should be able to kill all of them with those hits. Meanwhile, an ambulance in the background as usual, whenever I record, I get all the weird noises around my home as you can get, but I guess that's the part of life whenever you record with a mic as mine. Okay. Doesn't look like we got anything too crazy, but we got another healing skill, so I will gladly take it. Okay, let's go. We are completely ready for the boss, so I'm going to skip to the last room. After all, we have seen everything that Sheila can do in standard floors, so I should say that we can go directly to the boss, especially because I don't even think that I will need to pause the video to get to the last boss, because it is that easy with Sheila that I do not have any sort of worry about beating Volk at all. So let's just go straight to the end. This is something that I suggest to do whenever you are at the maximum level. You have every weapon you need, you have every shell skill you need, then there is really no reason on why you should farm anymore, aside from, of course, more resources. But in many cases, this does not really apply to me because I am not farming making the video. If I was farming, of course, I would do it off video. Anyway, here we are with Volk. So for bosses, to recap what I told you, you want to start with an S1, S2, S1, in this case like this. Of course, I did not hit Volk right there, but it is not a huge problem because I want to do it before he starts his attacks pattern, because then he gets kind of triggered to animations. Remember that changing 3 skills means a long animation time, which is something that of course means that you need to pay very careful attention about the boss, what he's doing, etc. Now, for Volca this is not a huge problem, but for other bosses this can be quite problematic, because of course there are some attacks that they do that can get caught into your rotation. Well, then that can be a big problem. In this case the boss will go down as easy as you can see, because of course Sheila is that strong. What you need to do, and what you need to remember, chain her attacks, make sure that she always is in a safe spot, even if she's doing a skill, for example right here, that we have to dodge multiple skills. Do not get careless about her positioning, because it can be quite dangerous, as you can see over here, for example, I made a mistake. Everything else, it is pretty easy to understand. She deals incredible damage, like the boss is already dead after not even 1 minute and something, and didn't even use one dragon. Like, I want to show you guys, because you wouldn't believe me, look at this. I have all my dragons, I didn't use one of them. She's this strong, I can guarantee you that you wouldn't regret it at all if you got Sheila from the Gacha, because she's indeed that strong, and the boss is now down. Now your question would be, is Sheila a character that is going to make it so this mod basically relies on her farming? No. There are 5 elements, so you can't only farm with Sheila, but for Fire, she's an ideal character to farm this mod with, for sure. I can also say that I am pretty good at her, because you've seen a pretty expert level of play today. Something that I'm not usually do. You have seen my past Kaleido showcases. This is not my optimal level of play, I will say as much. But I think I did very well with her, indeed. Let's see what we got. Dragon damage and critical damage is not too bad. First strike and critical damage also not too bad. You want critical damage from the prince. Critical damage, skill damage, strength, any of those work very well with her. Critical rate and less dragon damage, that's kinda bad. But the first two actually got my interest. Let's see what we got here. Dragon damage, this one is pretty actually this one can work with the build that I'm making, because I am lagging like 5% critical damage, so it can be pretty good. Ok, this one is very nice. She does not use force strike at all, but you get maxed out critical damage, at least as much maxed out as you can into those sprints, so it's not too bad at all. Basically you can place a critical damage 4 star print instead of 5 star, which opens up a 5 star slot. And the force strike is nice, I guess, if you force strike every now and then, but not really that needed. Then let's see what else we got here. Lucky Hitter, this actually is a maxed out print, one of the first that we got. Less critical rate, no, like, more critical rate, less dragon damage, but also HP 15%. I wonder if there is a fire dagger that can use this. I don't really think that there actually is currently. Like, anyone would also favor the dragon damage. But it is a nice print, at least, pretty unique for what it is. Ok, very nice, this is another showcase. Probably the shortest Kaleido showcase that we did, but with good reason, as you saw, because this character is quite insane. Hopefully you have already seen my standard showcase for Sheila. If you haven't, go check it out. But for today this is it, thank you very much for watching, remember to leave a like and a sub, and remember to roll for Sheila, even though probably this video has come out when her gacha has already run out. So hopefully you roll for Sheila, if you haven't, make sure to get her into the future, because she is very, very fun. Thank you very much for watching, remember to leave a like and a sub, and remember to tune in into the next Dragaost video. This has been Hunter Lodge, and for today, I'm out. Bye my friends!